is you're watching Good Day Live with Beth Vaughn and meteorologist Tom Hagen. Thanks for starting your day with us.
Good morning. Winter weather hit northeast Kansas overnight, leaving behind plenty of the white stuff. So be careful as you head out the door this morning. Tom, we were talking earlier. It took us about double the amount of time to get into work this morning.
Yeah, definitely. The snow had stopped for a little bit, but now it has returned, Beth. So it's going to be another slow go for the rest of this morning. Some light to moderate snow just now starting again here in Topeka. Let's take a look at what's going on live precision Doppler. And you can see particularly heavy tonight, 4 to 8 inches for Topeka. Can you believe that? We already have, Beth, about 2 to 3 on the ground, so expecting another 3 to 4 to come in later on today and especially tonight.
Just the beginning here, Tom.
It really is, and I do suggest if you do have to head out this morning, plan an extra 10, maybe 20 minutes to get to your destination safely.
Okay, good advice. Thank you, Tom. Folks across the region have been busy preparing for this blast of winter weather. The town of Seneca is expected to get as much as a foot of snow. 27 News reporter Amy Wolf spent yesterday afternoon there to find out what citizens are doing to prepare for that snowstorm.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Hey, welcome back. We're joined now by Jamie with the Topeka and Shawnee County Public Library, and you've brought one of your bookmobiles out for us this morning.
Yeah, we did. It's National Bookmobile Day, so we thought we'd come out and kind of let people see what we do with bookmobiles here, being
secure.
Legal. They're legal. They've got their seatbelt on.
Right, right. Yeah. There's also car seats for the kids'
car
books,
for
right?
Books.
Right, yeah.
Definitely.
Pretty cool. It's really neat how you have a
very
library.
Cool. Mobile library. Yeah, very neat. Well, thank you guys for coming out this morning. We certainly appreciate it. Now, Topeka is hosting its annual parade. It starts at noon and begins at 4th and Kansas downtown. It will then head south to 12th and Kansas, looping west to 12th and Jackson, before going north to 6th and Jackson, where the parade will end. Something you might notice this year, the parade has been renamed the Google St. Patrick's Day Parade in honor of the city's temporary name change from Topeka to Google, Kansas. Now let's check in with meteorologist Tom Hagen, who is live out at Texas Roadhouse. Tom, good morning.
Hey, good morning, Amy. I am live here at Texas Roadhouse, the new home of the Blarney Breakfast. They've been doing this for, 10 plus years, a great fundraiser for Easter Seals Capper Foundation. Come on out to Texas Roadhouse. The doors open here in about 15, 20 minutes at 6 o'clock, and the Blarney Breakfast runs until 10 o'clock this morning. $10 for adults, $5 for kids, and if you come before 8 o'clock this morning, you buy one kid, you get one free. And they have all sorts of food here at the Blarney Breakfast. They have sausage, biscuits and gravy, scrambled eggs, fruit, warm rolls, and cinnamon butter. So it's going to be delicious and a fun time here.
Hey, welcome back. Susan Morrell is joining us now, and she is a leader with Weight Watchers.
Yeah, you're going to give us some options for a healthier choice during March Madness games.
That's right, when you go to that concession stand. So we're going to start off with a hamburger or a hot dog, Tom. So what choice do you think would be the healthier choice there to get?
I would think the hot dog, because it doesn't look like there's as much.
Okay.
Is that wrong?
Well, actually, your hamburger is going to be your better choice. Of course, we hold the mayo and cheese, okay?
just a hamburger.
That's
plain.
Just a hamburger. And no chili on that hot dog, you see. That's
okay.
Just plain.
All right.
But you know what? It's all about size, really, because we can have whatever we want. But if we think about size, a small hamburger like this is going to come in about 250 calories, which is about 6 points at Weight Watchers. And the hot dog is going to come in at 300 calories, which is about 8 points at Weight Watchers. So you can actually, the hamburger would be your better choice there.
It'd be smarter to get maybe.
We're following breaking news this morning from Washington, D.C. The U.S. Senate has approved its version of the health care reform bill. During an early morning vote, the Senate passed the bill 60-39, straight along party lines. The Democratic-backed plan requires nearly all Americans to buy insurance and forbids companies from denying coverage based on pre-existing conditions. In January, lawmakers will start tough negotiations to ratify this bill with a similar version passed by the
Drew Colberth and his family are in Topeka this morning and spent the evening together last night at their church. After a whirlwind 3 weeks in Haiti, Colberth is finally home in Topeka with his loved ones. The father of four, along with three other missionaries, headed to Bethel Baptist Church, where Colberth is an assistant youth pastor. And since Colberth returned home yesterday, he has not spoken to the media until basically now. We're joined a very special occasion by 27 News anchors Mitch Weber and Kelly Stegman. You guys actually just had the opportunity to see Drew getting interviewed.
We did, and it was just about minutes ago. We just left the location, and it was really great getting to talk to them. We talked
some sparkling grape juice here for Kansas today. Today, January 29th in 1861, Kansas entered the Union as the 34th state. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
And so to celebrate, my spilling on the desk, to celebrate that, we have some sparkling cider. We have our party hats. It's Kansas's birthday. How old are we today?
149.
149 years old.
And it is sparkling.
It is sparkling. It's not the fourth hour of today.
No.
Yet.
Almost.
Almost. Right. let me give you some trivia, Amy, about Kansas. Hey, welcome back. If you're in the mood for a little country twang this Christmas season, we have a fun event for you this weekend.
That's right. We have Kathy and BJ Forgy here from the 2009 Chuckwagon Dinner and Dance.
How about this time of winter? I shiver when I see the falling snow. If we make it through December, got plans to be in a warmer town come summertime. Maybe even California.
Had an affinity for donuts. You haven't met Tom and I yet. Hey, you guessed it. It's The Simpsons. And guess what? It's the 20th anniversary of that great show this weekend. They're going to have a show or kind of a special here, a 20th anniversary special, starting at 7 o'clock on Fox 43. That is this Sunday, January 10th, starting at 7. That's Homer's Affinity for Donuts. And then they'll have a 3D special at 7:30. So don't miss both of those.
Yeah, it's the 450th episode, Once Upon a Time in Springfield. The show debuted.
And now we are going to read your comments from Facebook Friday. We wanted to know, what did you think about the push for bringing Google's high-speed optic internet here to Topeka?
Exactly,
it's a very many words. It's a lot of words. But anyway, we've had some responses to our question. And do you want to read Christy's?
All right. This is from Christy. She says, I think we should get the Google to come to Topeka. But if we don't, I think we should not give up.
Yeah, that's right. Continue to make Topeka a better place. Yeah. Michelle says, yes, we want Google. I think Topeka gets an A+ for effort and will get the Google experiment if community rally is a factor, which is a really good point. Yeah. She goes on to say,
classic love songs.
Classic love songs. All right. And you guys are going to sing one for us now, right?
Yeah, we sure are.
Very cool. All right. We'll have you take it away. Good luck, guys.
Heart of my heart, I love you. Life would be not without you. Light of my life, my darling.
Welcome back to Good Day Live. We have a very special interview coming to us from Iraq. This might be an early Christmas present for some families in our area. I am joined now by three soldiers from Fort Riley who are joining us from Iraq. Hey guys, why don't you introduce yourselves to our audience and hopefully your family.
Hi, my name is CW2 Shane Walrod. I'm from Cheyenne, Wyoming.
My name is Sergeant First Class Carl Manns. I'm from South Bend, Indiana.
My name is Sergeant First Class Richard Overby from Augusta, Wisconsin.
Augusta, Wisconsin. So how are you guys spending Christmas?